So you've had a city that struggled for decades, I think, with water issues.
Water loss had been growing over the past 25 years to where we really have to produce double what we need in order to just survive.
When you get on national and international news for not having water, it's hard for businesses to operate.
It's been seriously underinvested over the last probably 7 years, culminating in the federally declared disaster in August of 22.
So in August 2022, the city had just come off the back of a flood event, and we started to hear rumbles from the water plant that we were about to lose pressure, we were about to lose service to the city.
And so our role is to stabilize and try to put JXN Water on a sustainable path forward. My initial thought process was I need national firms, and then I looked for national firms with a JXN presence.
JXN Water stood up a complete staff in an impressive amount of time. We've tried to be part of that solution for them. We function as an extension of their staff. But essentially, you're standing up an entire utility in a matter of months.
It seems like Stantec can produce a person for everything I ask. It's really cool. They might be from all over the country. They might be from out of the country, even.
One of the first projects we did was to repair a 48-inch transmission line. It's estimated they were losing somewhere between 4 and 5 million gallons a day at that one single break.
We got a team in from Texas that specializes in that type of work. They knocked that out. That was a big win for the entire program here in JXN to stop that leak. Along with that has been a lot more design work and construction in preparation for a lot of pipe replacements. And we're overseeing 18 task orders we have right now. Our initial task when we got here were to develop a hydraulic model. They did not have a model of the system, and that hydraulic model is your roadmap to everything you're going to be doing to improve the system. One of the other initial tasks was to develop a GIS map of the entire system.
To me, the mapping work is actually the most important. Stantec was given the impossible task of taking over 20,000 drawings and making them make sense and become usable, and finding a way to digitize those drawings, get them into GIS where they're readable, while simultaneously keeping up with locks crews in the field who needed data in order to do their work.
We have about 25 people on the GIS team who are taking these hand-drawn ancient drawings and figuring out where they relate in space, and then hand-digitizing all of the assets from those drawings, so figuring out where the meters are, where the pipes are, what size pipes they are, how old the pipes are. So we're building this digital twin, in a sense, from the ground up of where all of the water assets are in the city of JXN.
We're going to do a service line inventory as part of the EPA's lead and copper rule. So we're doing an inventory of all 55 JXN public schools to check the status of their service line for their water service. We just want to make sure that the system that we're working on does not have lead service lines or lead lines themselves.
Infrastructure has such a difficult impact on everything. It's hard to invite new businesses in. It's hard to invite new development in when they don't have a level of confidence that the infrastructure is going to be there.
There are a lot of great things going on in JXN. You can invest in this community. You can invest in this city, and there's a good reason to invest in this community. In 2019, we broke ground, and so we've had three businesses that were open, you know, in 2020, and then 21, 22 brought the brewery online and apartments, and so we've kind of been incrementally developing out these two blocks. Having this fixed, it makes it where people can now, like I said, they can plan.
I went to college here in JXN, Mississippi. This was my home for 4.5 years. I can't even describe how much it means to be able to be a part of trying to restore this.
We've seen a lot of improvements in just 10 months that we've been here. And it's not just because of Stantec. It's a larger effort. There's subcontractors, construction contractors, other consultants. Everybody's working together.
We're not just making necessary emergency repairs. A lot of the work we are doing is proactive in trying to get the system into a state of manageable condition to where you're not fighting the same battles day after day.
Reliability and trust is the key to building anything, right?
We're here for a common goal, and that's to make Jax's lives better.
160,000 people want water every day, and they should have water every day. That's what drives us.